Hey guys, today I'm going to take you into the world of Sherlock Holmes, a character, a literary character who has evolved multiple times over the long number of decades since he has come to life through Arthur Conan Doyle, and the most recent one being the BBC show called The Sherlock, and Benedict Cumberbatch and Martin Freeman epitomized it and took it to another level altogether. A simple testimony to that is the IMDb rating of 9.1 for the show, and which I simply loved it. So that's the reason why I got these two books which you see in front of me. This is the manga format of that show which I have here. So I am not a connoisseur or a big reader of manga in any sort of scenario, but I simply loved Sherlock, and that's the reason why I went ahead and got this mangas to read. So it's a completely new different experience for me, and that's what I'm going to take you through you guys today. So today we'll talk about The Blind Banker, because I finished reading the book. This one is still shrink wrapped, as you can see, and I will do a separate review of this one. So let's get right to it. Right, so let's start. First thing you would notice about a manga, if you are not a manga fan or have not read a manga before, it's read the reverse way, right? So you start from the back and then you move forwards to the beginning, right? If you look at the other way, usually when you hold the book, you will see the last end page in my hand, right? I simply loved the way Watson and Sherlock is portrayed in this book and drawn. And to give you some sense, the story in this book is exactly how it is in the show. Nothing changes. Obviously, there are some pattern changes that adaptations simply meant for the comic format, but otherwise, it's entirely the same. So, if you guys are going into this expecting a different story, no, that's not the case. But if you loved the show, I think this is a must have, right? Because it's a different format, I feel, to read it. I mean, I felt it's engaging and keeps you enthralled throughout. I'm sure you guys would know the story of The Blind Banker, because that story is part of the original Arthur Conan Doyle Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. If I remember correctly, it's called The Dancing Men, The Adventures of the Dancing Men. So that got personified in this Sherlock story. This is episode number 2 of the Sherlock series. I think the first one was A Study in Pink. I don't have that book, unfortunately, but maybe I'll get it. So what's happening here, and they show it pretty early, is this one, right? So he is the blind banker. So what you see here are ciphers written all over the place. And these ciphers are meant for some specific people, right? And it's carrying a message across to them, right? It's a warning for them. And soon, once Sherlock gets involved, he discovers that there are murders happening, right? For the people who are meant to understand the ciphers, they are getting killed. And I simply love the artwork which you guys see. It's a simple black and white art, as you guys can see, and it has the cover pages from the show. Which I simply love, right? Not much colors, but I don't think that has taken the sheen of it in any sort of manner. And there are a lot of different kind of communications, right? All the words which cuts across the panels, which is brilliant. and some beautiful landscape as well drawn all over the place. So yeah, into the story itself, right? As Sherlock dives deeper, and the best part of this book is that it captures his thoughts, his deduction methods, all of that in a very 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 interesting way, so that you don't lose any of it simply because you are reading a book, right? And and those places where he notices how things have been moved, his deduction techniques, all that comes into front in these panels. So it's a big book, although it's short, it's a small book, right? As you can see, it's not a big book, but it has a lot of pages in it, and it's brought out by Bloomsbury. So, and it's definitely available on print on Amazon from where I got it. So the story then revolves, and then I don't want to go into the details and spoil it for you guys. So the plot thickens around the gang of Black Lotus and what's happening with them smuggling items onto London is how the story goes around. So if you ask me, should you purchase this or not, I think definitely yes, because it's not too costly, as well as if you guys loved the show, I think this is a brilliant way to like own a part of it in your hands, right? And I, after reading it, I feel a lot like going back and rereading it again, right? And this is one of the best books which I've read, in which I simply loved the black and white feel to it. So I'll just give you few glimpse of what extras it carries, because it does carry some extras, although not much. These are, and it has this simple and elegant sketches at the end, which is also pretty nice, and I would love to have the entire collection with me someday, and this double page splash of Sherlock and Watson. And the other interesting part is their faces are exactly like how it is in the show. So these are the extras they have, some cover gallery of from the show itself, right? And I simply love this one where both of their faces are printed in the currencies, right? And then you have some, I think these are the covers from the single issues which got published. I think this was originally published in Japanese and then got translated into English is what I feel. I'm not sure, but the artwork, the story, everything is so brilliant. This is the way you read it, right? They shown it right in the end on how to read the book, which is pretty interesting. And yeah, so that's it, guys, right? So I just wanted to show so the writer is Steve Thompson, co-creators are Steven Moffat and Mark Geddes, and art is by Jay. So that's where I will leave you guys, and my plan is to cover this one the next time, which is The Great Game, right? So that is going to come up next for you guys in my next video. So thanks for watching, do subscribe, bye bye.